Hey, what's going on, guys? Austin Harga here, aka Dr. Welds, and I'm on the set of WeldTube as an ambassador for Weld.com, and we've got a great video today. We're gonna TIG weld up some carbon steel, and I'm gonna show you how to get those fancy, pretty colors. We're gonna get some gold on that cap, all right? So y'all stick around, you might learn something. We gotta talk about setup, we gotta talk about prep, we gotta talk about fit, we gotta talk about size of pipe, all that kind of stuff. So today, we're gonna be running our TIG welding process. I've got some 2% thoriated tungsten, 70S 6 wire, that good stuff. We're gonna be working on schedule 120 right here. It's some nice thick wall. We're working with a 3/16 gap, all right? That's my personal preference. I like a wide gap so I can get that root in there nice and secure. We're gonna be able to get a root in there at about 100 amps. We're gonna go ahead and tack it on all four sides, about a half inch long tack on all each sides, and then we'll go from there. All right, so we're looking at it. We wanna make sure the high-low's all good. We've got it prepped inside, out, bevels are shiny. You want a nice, good TIG weld, you gotta weld over something nice and clean, right? So we wanna make sure we keep it that way. The one big tip to getting color on carbon steel is heat input. Having some thicker wall is gonna help. Schedule 40, schedule 80, can it be done? Sure, but it's pretty tough. You gotta be smoking it. So let's get this thing tacked up. All right, so we're gonna strike our arc. We're gonna stick it to the top bevel here, pull it down, keeping that wire kind of towards the back edge of our bevel to make sure our tacks are gonna look just like our root pass. Kind of freehanding these tacks in at 100 amps. We're gonna rotate it. Move it to the complete opposite side, and we're gonna check this opposite side. We want it to match, right? And we can kind of get our filler metal in there, kind of give it a wiggle to make sure we've got the room that we need. That's gonna help me get the root that I want as far as some good reinforcement. So now we're gonna go on the complete opposite side and put this second tack in. Start on the top bevel, light up, get a little puddle on the top, pull it down to the bottom edge, keep that wire towards the top with this big gap. If you start putting that wire towards the bottom, you're gonna notice you're gonna get a little undercut across the top. So keep that in mind, keep that wire towards the top while it's in this 2G position. We're gonna look, I can see I got a bigger gap on this side, so I'm gonna give it a nice molly whop. To bring down that side, and that ought to do it. Now we've got even gaps all the way around, we can put these other two tacks in. All right, guys, so now we got the pipe tacked up. We've got it in the 5G position where it's running horizontal with the ground, right? So we've got a nice fit up. We've got everything cleaned up. Now let's talk a little bit about that root, okay? We're running at 100 amps, right? That's gonna keep it at a nice pace. You know, if you're a little bit slower, maybe turn it down. If you're quick about it, maybe turn it up a little bit. You know, everyone does it a little different. We're gonna come in from the side tack here and we're actually gonna back feed this bottom, keeping that wire towards the back, working edge to edge. We're gonna be working touching those edges and getting up it in a hurry, you know? So once we're grabbing that wall, we're grabbing those edges, we're good to go. Again, 100 amps, 35 CFH on our argon, TIG welding process. You wanna learn more pointers about this, go check out our Weld app. We've got a great community on there, great educational videos where you can even find jobs. Get on that Weld app today, it's on the Google Play Store and Apple Store, a great resource for all welders around the world. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna make sure we're hanging on the bottom side of that tack. And using it as a brace as we come up the side, you're gonna wanna feed more and slower on the bottom than compared to as you start coming up this sidewall, you're gonna wanna work towards just the edge of that bevel. You don't wanna be too far in or we're gonna get too heavy of a root. So make sure you're staying at the edge and make sure your tungsten is able to reach down into this bevel. We've gotta work right into those edges. Our tungsten has to hit that wire right there on those edges. We've got to be able to reach down to those points right here and here. We want to be right on top of it. If we have our tungsten too far back into that cup, we're not going to be able to reach down there, and this wire is going to be balling up and these edges are going to be melting. So we need enough stick out to reach down into that deep bevel and be able to bounce side to side up this wire. All right, let's get after it. Light up on that tack. Get it nice and hot till we get to the edge of it. Watch the edge of that tack burn back before you introduce any filler. You're You're gonna wanna feed into that root down there at the bottom. Nice and easy. If you don't put a little feed in it, you're probably gonna get a nice flat root. Working edge to edge. This 100 amps is letting me take my time. I can even pop out of that puddle, grab some more wire. No problemo. Edge to edge, keeping that wire where it needs to be. Try to be centered. If the gap gets wide, we'll kind of bounce and dance with it back and forth. Don't want to get any cold wire, so we can't go too fast. All right, now we got one side in. Let's go ahead and do the other. Remember, we're going to light up on this tack right in the middle, get up to the edge of it, introduce our wire, and we've got to give a little bit of a feed into it, using that tack on the side as a brace. Let's get at it. Working side to side, the gap's a little snugger over here, that's fine. Do our best to keep that wire, kind of split the difference of this bevel and just wiggling up. And the more you get to this side, the more that wire pops out like that, you're gonna get a little bit of a nugget on the inside. So just keep that in mind. The more consistent you can keep your wire in there, the more consistent your root's gonna look. Getting up to the tack, wiggle up that tack. Get to it, wait till it keyhole is open. Then I can reintroduce my wire. And then wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Getting a tighter gap, I can feel that wire not wanting to just fall in there now. It's kind of lay wiring, so we're gonna even go a tighter gap, or tighter wiggle, and apply a little bit of pressure. We're gonna dab this hole closed. I'm even gonna add a little extra wire and just sit on it a little longer. Watch that wire sink into it. Wiggle, 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 wiggle faster, tail up the side of the bevel. So now we got the bead in there. As you saw before, it was nice and gold color. That's because this pipe was nice and cold. It had plenty of meat in this pipe to pull that heat and kind of keep that color on there on as far as the carbon steel. Now we're gonna work our way to the hot pass. You're gonna notice that it might get a little bit less gold to it, but a couple other fancy colors in there. We're gonna walk over to the machine. We're gonna bump this thing up. We're gonna hot pass this sucker at 200 amps right off the jump, right? And the thing with running 200 amps on a hot pass, we gotta be very careful on the bottom side of that pipe. As soon as we light up, we gotta get that wire in there pretty quick. If we spend too much time on the bottom, we're gonna suck back that root. So make sure when you're running something hot like this, if you wanna take your time, maybe go down to about 170, 150 would be kinda cold for something this thick. So I'm running 200 amps. As soon as I light that arc, I'm gonna get that wire in there quick to make sure that I'm gonna melt this to the pipe and not get that puddle to pull back our root. So let's get this hot pass in there. Going just a little bit wider than our root pass, keeping a nice even motion. We don't want to spend too much time in one location with this 200 amps. We're already going to be cooking that root, giving it a nice finish. The hot pass is going to set that root in there good at 200 amps. So let's not spend too much time in one location, otherwise we're going to do a lot of damage on the inside of that pipe and pulling back our root. Nice even travel speed. That's also going to be how you're going to succeed as far as getting some good color. The slower you go, the more it's going to start kind of oxidizing at a quicker rate, and you'll see that you'll start getting away from that color and into that gray kind of color scheme. I like taking bigger steps than some. You want to see a nice clean hot pass. You'll probably notice a nice line right up the middle of this hot pass when I'm finished. One crucial part, just like the root, when you get to finishing your hot pass, you need to make sure you tail out or pull to the edge of that bevel, because you are likely to leave a fisheye if you don't. All right, the hot pass is schlicked in there, right? It's good and crispy, the root's taken care of. Now we're gonna start hogging in some metal. So I went up to some 532/70S6 wire, a little bit bigger, a little bit thicker, because we're gonna put a little bit more metal in it, right? I got my nice heat pad on there, so this pipe's gonna start cooking, so I don't want my fingers to do so. I don't care to freehand it because I don't like burning up my fingertips, so I am gonna keep walking it. Whenever you're doing heavy fills like this, you gotta pay attention to the depth of the bevel, the very deepest part. If you notice a roll at the deepest part of your bevel, you're probably getting lack of fusion at the bottom of that weld. So make sure that you kind of wash out the bottom and then feed into the top. I kind of do a little dance with it as I go about filling this heavy fill. We're gonna be taking our time. We have enough weld in there that we can focus on doing a lot of heat input and fill in without pulling back our root. So Let's weld this sucker.
We're gonna start off with a little bit of fill and then work into really grabbing some extra. I like to come across that puddle, fill, pull the wire out, keep it in the argon shield, and then wash back to the other side so that I can make sure that I'm tying everything in. Fill, wash, fill, wash. Wire gets hung up, that's all right. We'll just get that puddle back in there. These fills ain't trying to be pretty. We're just trying to get this pipe finished. Try not to get in a hurry. Don't step too big. We want to keep a nice tight puddle so the heat stays in one location. I'm thinking I'm going to need to turn up my amps from 200. Really watching the fill, just kind of watching the bevel edges, kind of making sure I stay at least even on those bevel edges, and then the depth of the puddle, I can still see that I'm getting fusion in the bottom of it. It's really important.
Not worried about putting any pretty on it, we're just worried about putting some big fills. As you can see, the heat input is a lot more now. Now you see, and we're getting a lot of gray color as far as the oxidation on the weld, and this is gonna continue all the way out to our final fill, and then we're gonna clean it, cool it, and then we'll cap it. All right, guys, well, now we got that butter pass in there. Again, we had a root pass, we had a hot pass, we had one fill, then a big old hog of a fill, and then a two bead fill on top of that for this one schedule 120 heavy wall. We wanna make sure when we got this fill done that the center of our fill is a little bit past flush. The edges are okay to be about flush, but we want a nice little crown on there. That way when we go to cap it, we don't have to worry about filling. My motto is when you think it's full, put some more into it. You wanna be able to run your hand across it and feel a little bit of a bump, especially in the middle of that weld. That way when you go to put your cap on there, you're not trying to spend so much time trying to fill, and you're just able to slick one on there real good. So to get gold, as you can see on here, we're back to gray. We got gray color, there's no gold on it. There is so much heat. This sucker is spicy, right? So we gotta take some time. We gotta let this sucker cool off. And when I can sit here and grab it with my bare hand, then we're ready to cap, and then we'll get back to what we saw on that root, which is a nice shiny gold color. All right, nice and cooled off. Now we can start putting the cap on here. We're gonna maintain 200 amps. It's gonna let us move fast. Fast and hot is gonna be the trick for this. Now, as far as the size of the weld, we can't go more than three sizes the diameter. That's the rule of thumb for the filler metal that we're using. I'm using a 1/8 70S 6 rod, so we can't just put some big old fat weaves on here. So we're gonna do a three bead cap on here, side by side, staggered.
Stand up. Always keeping your head in front of your torch. It's gonna let you see your arc length a lot better. If you ever find yourself behind your torch, you're probably gonna end up slipping. So either stop, reposition, or stand up, move with the pipe, move with the torch. You know, we're trying to cap hot and fast. 200 amps on something like this isn't that hot, especially if you're a production welder and you're working in position on a rollout machine. You know, you could probably be cooking these suckers at closer to 300. But the fact that we're working in position, 5G, I've got to get underneath it. Gravity is working against me. I've got to move around. 200 amps is something I'm comfortable with doing.
One more game. Let's get back to the bottom and back to the top.
Only really looking to get a 16th of an inch outside that bevel, outside my weld area, you know. I don't want to go too wide, because then we're going to be out of code, out of tolerance. So I'm making sure that I cover the highest point of the previous weld and only going about a 16th of an inch outside my bevel edge. Typically this bead being probably my smallest bead of the three.
That's how we're going to do it, guys. Remember, how to get gold on carbon steel has really got to do with a couple of variables. Heat input is the biggest thing. The thicker the pipe, the easier it's gonna be. Just simple as that. Travel speed, amperage, gas coverage, all those marry up together to make one gold cap on some carbon steel. I wanna thank WeldTube for having Weld.com and myself out here. If you like what you saw today, please like, follow, and subscribe. Not only myself, Dr. Welds, WeldTube, and Weld.com. And if you want to see more great content like this, check out our Weld app. That's all I got for you today. Doctor's orders.